Welcome to the Loft in downtown, uptown Columbus, Georgia. It's a pleasure to have you here this evening. I thank you so much. It warms my heart to see so many people here to hear the Schwob Jazz Orchestra. My name is Dr. Kevin Whalen, and I am the fortunate person who gets to direct this band. This is the Schwob Jazz Orchestra, and we're going to have quite a treat for you tonight. We've got a lot of things, so we hope you stick around. But you didn't come here to hear me talk, so let's get started with a little Love for Sale.
Thank you.
Johnson on alto saxophone. Stephen Lippard on trumpet. Brian Tenonio on tenor saxophone. And with a fierce and somewhat aggressive count-off, a la Buddy Rich, Dan Murray on drums. Again, that's one of my favorites from the library, the great drummer Buddy Rich, really great writing for the band. We're going to move on because we've just got so much to bring you tonight. We're going to do a little arrangement from the library of Count Basie off an album called I Told You So. This is Sweet Pea.
Thank you.
So we thought we'd get them on stage here before they go on to bigger and better things. So we're going to sort of have two different sets of vocalists. But we're going to start things off with some stuff from the Count Basie Orchestra, and we're going to start this off. This is from an album that came out in 1988. Count Basie collaborated with some of his favorite arrangers, notably Frank Foster and Bob Florence, and brought out a great album with Diane Schur. Does anybody know anything about Diane Schur? Okay, well, wonderful jazz vocalist. We have the original parts for that, and I thought we would use that as a platform to feature our first vocalist tonight, Victoria Evans Cash. Woo! From the stage. Again, we're going to feature Victoria on an old standard that I'm sure many of you know and love. This is We'll Be Together Again.
Don't let the blues make you bad. Victoria.
Victoria Evans Cash on vocals. Victoria Evans Cash on vocals. What a wonderful arrangement. I love that. That album's been fantastic, and I think Victoria just does a wonderful job taking on the vocals of Diane. Sure. We're going to bring up another jazz vocalist. And interestingly enough, it's Allison Kircher's birthday today. And we figure nothing would make her birthday more special than her getting to sing with the Schwob Jazz Orchestra. So what great timing. Allison joined us a couple of years ago, but she was actually a flute performance major. She came here playing the flute, but she said, I want to play jazz. I've sung jazz. I know jazz. And she took all the classes. She's actually graduating with a certificate in jazz studies, in a couple of weeks, right? Moving on into a career in musical therapy down at Florida State University. So one of her many talents is jazz singing. We're going to bring her up to play one of my old favorite tunes. This is called Almost Like Being in Love. Allison Kircher.
Has been, what a mood I am in, why it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race, why it's almost like being in love. All the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. When that bell starts to peal, I could swear I was falling. I swear I was falling. It's almost like being in
back home.
great after being out late, walking my baby back home. Arm in arm over meadow and farm, walking my baby back home. We go along, harmonizing a song, while I recite a poem. One kiss, then I continue again, walking my baby back home. She's starting again. Da-da-da-da-da. She snuggles her head on my chest. We starting to pet, and that's when I get a talcum all over my vest. After I sort of strain my tie, she has to borrow my comb. One kiss, then I continue again, walking my baby back home. Of the dark, so I have to park outside of her door till it's light. She says if I try to kiss her, she'll cry. I'll dry her tears all through the night. Hand in hand at the barbecue stand, right from her doorway we roam. Eats and then it's a pleasure again, walking my baby, talking my baby, loving my baby. I don't mean maybe, walking my baby back home.
And a little bit of jazz vibes, along with our other illustrious drummer, Mr. Tommy Imbrick, who also has a recital tomorrow. If you're interested in hearing a lot of fantastic percussion, there's like 5 percussion recitals tomorrow in Legacy Hall starting around noon. I think Tommy's first. So if you're interested in hearing classical percussion, we've got a place for you tomorrow. We're going to move on. We've got one more chart until we get to the main event, or one of our featured people here tonight, which is the great Andrea J. Freedy. But we're going to first feature another special uprising jazz musician here in the Schwob School of Music. Yes. Please bring Elizabeth Schlender to the stage. I remember, like it was yesterday, but it was actually a whole year ago, Elizabeth was at a concert, it may have been this one, and she said, I play jazz and I want to play jazz here. Can I do that here? And, well, of course you can play jazz here. It's a wonderful thing. The violin is one of the original jazz instruments, and it's one of the best things to incorporate into a band whenever you get the opportunity. This chart, written by a guy in Florida named Chuck Owen, has incorporated the violin fantastically into this. And we're going to get to hear her add to the texture and also solo a little bit back and forth with Brian Canonigo on tenor. So this is Chuck Owen's Glib featuring Brian Canonigo and Elizabeth Schlender on violin.
Thank you.
Show, and believe it or not, this gentleman that just arrived from Milan, Italy, I guess 2 days ago, has been to Columbus, Georgia before. He was here for the International Trumpet Guild Convention, which I believe took place in 2012, may have been 13, and he was here and played and was featured with orchestras and jazz bands and just left such an incredible impression on the people at the conference and in the city that when we had that he was coming back to do a short tour in America, we decided we would join that tour and bring him here tonight for this show. And he did wonderful things in being flexible with us and letting us come and have hear him play one more time. So he actually was wonderful in letting us bring him back to Columbus. His name is Andrea Giofridi. Andrea Giofridi. We have him in the house. Yeah. Bring him to the stage. Andrea Giofridi. A little tight up here, friends. It's a little bit tight up here. The story is, you pick up that jacket here on Broadway. Is that true? It is true. He bought it here. He got a souvenir from Columbus.
Do
Georgia.
You like?
In any case, Andrea Giofridi.
Okay. Do you like my jacket?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I buy it in Columbus. It's very special.
Looks good. Andrea is one of the finest trumpet players on the planet today. I've heard him play several times. I used to watch videos of him when I was much younger than this. I used to watch him on YouTube and think, gee, can anybody play the trumpet like that and get away? I mean, it seems so easy. So we're going to play a lot of music that he selected, and we're going to start off with something from the library of Harry James. This is, as pronounced by him, Chitty Bitty Ben. I think that we had a debate in the band about how to pronounce that all week. But finally, Andrea settled the score. And it is Chitty Bitty Ben featuring the one and only Andrea Giofridi.
This is not sunglasses. It's for read the music.
Thank you.
good event. Yeah, it's a little bit fun. We're going to move on. Set list while you wait, as they say. We're going to move on with another thing. This is a Ted Heath Orchestra big band chart. Comes out of, many of you who don't know Ted Heath, Ted Heath was probably the most prominent British big band leader in the post-war era. He led bands all around, especially when big bands hit its release date, payday, over in Europe. And he led bands all over and sort of took on the tradition of Glenn Miller and Tommy Dorsey and Buddy Benny Goodman and all the wonderful American swing big bands, but he did it overseas. So sometimes we as Americans don't really get to hear a lot of this music, but Andrea suggested we do this old ballad called Memories of You, and it's one of the favorites from the Ted Heath Orchestra Library, and I think he plays a wonderful job. I can see why he picked it. So, without further ado, this is Memories of You. This chart at Soundcheck, and that's the second time they've ever played it. So, Andrea came to rehearsal today, and he said, there's this chart I would love to do, and he asked us if we could do it, and I said, well, what do you think? And the guy said, well, of course we can. So the power of sight reading is sort of one of the things we preach here all the time, and it's wonderful to see that they're able to perform something virtually sight reading it for you tonight. You probably wouldn't have guessed. So, let's give it up to the band. We're going to finish up with one more tune before we take a set break. And this is from an album that I listened to many, many years ago, Body and Soul by Maynard Ferguson. As a trumpet player myself, I didn't escape the allure of Maynard Ferguson, Maynard the Fox, great Canadian trumpet player, great, wonderful musician that inspired so many of us. And he put out this album and called Body and Soul, and this was called The Dive. And then it was redone called The Last Dive many, many years later and rearranged by a guy named Matt Harris. And tonight, we're going to use this opportunity to feature Nick Johnson on alto saxophone playing the part of Maynard Ferguson. Big shoes to fill, but he'll be okay. So this is, he'll be all right. This is The Last Dive by Matt Harris. Thank you. Nick Johnson on alto saxophone. We're just going to take a few minutes break, reset our chops, and we'll be back with another set of musics. Please stay where you are. Thank you so much for being here tonight. We'll be right back. Good evening. Welcome back. I hate to interrupt the drinking and the socializing, but we've got some more music to play for you tonight, and we've got to get things moving, or we won't get to play it all for you, and that'd be a horrible shame. We're going to move on, and like I said, we've got three great vocalists, an incredible trumpet player, and more importantly, an incredible band behind me tonight that can't wait to play for you. We're going to start things off with an Alan Baylock arrangement of an old doo-wop tune called One Mint Julep. It was actually one of the first commercially popular drinking songs. It was played on the radio by, I think it was the Clovers. In any case, they're famous for Love Potion No. 9 and a lot of other sort of 50s doo-wop and rock and roll early styles of that. This has been rearranged by the director of jazz studies in North Texas. I think it sounds fantastic. So this is One Mint Julep. Thank you. Stephen Lucart. Nick Johnson. Rustin Shores. I didn't know that trombone could play that low. It's always exciting. Every year about this time, a lot of people move on to bigger and greater things, and I guess that's our job because we're a school. We want them to graduate and move forward. And I always have these moments of fear, like, what are we going to do next year? And then I hear things coming out of guys like Wes and Steven, and I'm thinking, we're going to be just fine because these young folks have sort of answered the call and always rise up. We're going to be busy next year. So, moving forward, we're going to bring another vocalist to the stage. It's her birthday. I'll say it again. And she's going to sing a tune that many people cherish, but it's probably most famous because Ella Fitzgerald made it famous, and it's called Blue Skies. So we're going to bring Allison Kirshner to the stage to sing the arrangement of Blue Skies. Jazz drummer, jazz vibraphonist, aspiring. You need to run your own band, Dan.
You're right.
Got any names for it? just as soon as he finishes all those finals and tests and juries and plays his recital tomorrow, he'll have all the time in the world. Is that right, Dan?
True.
Got any band names? Not yet. You got to work on that.
Come back to me on that.
Okay, great. Fantastic. So. So, the Danimal? Okay, so one of the most swingingest albums to ever get recorded and released, the most swingingest, happened at the Sands Casino in Las Vegas. And it featured not only the wonderful Frank Sinatra on vocals, that was only part of the story, and that would already be a good story if Frank was on stage, but he was backed by the wonderful Count Basie Orchestra and directed by none other than Quincy Jones. So Quincy Jones, Count Basie, Frank Sinatra made for quite a mix. This arrangement, which I'm sorry to say is probably ripped off of one of those recordings and laden with inaccuracies, it's pretty good though. It's good enough, right? And it's a tune that many of you know and love. It's one of Frank's signature pieces, and when I asked Dan to play this, he said, I already know it. This is Frank Sinatra's I've Got You Under My Skin.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. I tried so not to give in. I said to myself, this affair never will go so well. But why should I try to resist when, baby, I know so well I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything come what might for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats, repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. Oh, but each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. But I've got you under my skin. Sacrifice anything come what might for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. Oh, but each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. 'Cause I've got you under my skin. Yes, I like you under my skin.
Now he just needs to find a band. I can't recall if that arrangement was Nelson Riddle. We think it was Nelson Riddle. And the thing about it is that bass trombone line.
Woo! Yeah.
And that short solo, these young cats don't understand how important those 8 bars of big band are. I said, if there was an excerpt that you had to play for all big bands for bass trombone players, this would be on there. This is one of those famous lines, and I was telling Jeremy Cover, by the way, Cover, it's his first semester in the band, I was telling him, hey man, this is an important thing, and I said, you really can't play too loudly on this, just as long as you're in time. I don't even care if you're a little bit sharp, it'll be fine. It's supposed to sound a little bit trombone-like, you know? And he and the rest of the cast stepped up and did marvelously. We've got one more vocalist for you tonight. You've already met her. Her name is Victoria Evans Cash. Welcome here to the stage. Completing this little subset of Diane Schur and Count Basie was the signature tune of Diane Schur. She had this nickname. Her nickname was Deedles. I don't know why that was her nickname. I'm sure there's a wonderful jazz article written about it that I didn't have time to read this semester. However, that was her nickname. That's what people called her. And so we've got this great arrangement from Frank Foster. Pretty sure it's Frank Foster. Was this Bob Lawrence? Yeah, Frank Foster. That was written for her and the band. And it's really just a blues, but it's Deedles blues. And it's going to feature the whole band and probably one of my favorite vocal charts. This is the one, the only, Victoria Evans Cash singing Diane Schur's version of Deedles Blues.
I got a brand new man. I'm telling you, he loves me like nobody can. Well, I met him on the corner. It was pouring rain. Yes, I met him on the corner. It was pouring rain. He said, come on over, baby. Tell me what's your name.
Let's give it up to Victoria. Victoria and his cast. You got another performance major here in the vocal studio. And if you want to hear her sing again, there's a vocal concert under Dr. Jan Baridi. And she'll be being featured with the group singing a Paris Rutherford arrangement, A Lot of Leaves, on Monday. So if you want to check that out, I encourage you to do so. Wonderful vocalist, right? Woo! Wonderful. Woo! We're going to move on and bring the undisputed star, as demonstrated by the blazer, to the stage. This is the wonderful Andrea Giafridi. Andrea Giafridi. So Andrea came to us with a series of charts, and we got some of them, not just today, we got some of them a little while ago, and one of my favorites comes from some of the 60s collection of Duke Ellington. And this chart is going to feature him playing a Duke Ellington arrangement of, or a composition of, called The Eighth Veil. The Eighth Veil. Band, cast on the band, calling an audible. The Eighth Veil. While it's getting set up here, it's wonderful to get to hear everything that the Duke did throughout his career, but one of the things that stands out to me is how he evolved as a composer and as a musician. And this doesn't sound anything like this stuff from the 30s, but there are traces of it. It really does sound like the 60s. Duke was staying with the times, and he was very much writing with that sort of very present, post-Gil Evans orchestrated big band jazz. And, of course, Duke was sort of the beginning of that and the middle of that and the end of that. But this represents some of my favorite writing from his work. So, without any other delays, Andrea Giafridi on The Eighth Veil. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Please. Volume.
Volume. Grazie. Oh, thank you. So, what I mean, it's difficult for me to play because I have big jet lag. For me, now is maybe, yes, 4 in the night. Quarter or 4. Maybe. Normally, I don't play. I sleep this time. So, difficult. Okay. What is the next?
You made me love you.
Okay.
That's right. We brought him in, and fortunately, CSU has tremendous international accommodations that we bring in people in all disciplines, and there's actually apartments just across the street next to the Chili Thai restaurant between that and the pod. There are actually international apartments there. We bring in folks, again, all over the place. So he's living downtown amongst us and has been here for a couple of days.
That's why he's tired.
What's up?
That's why he's tired.
That's why he's tired. He's been in downtown a couple of us too long. Uptown Columbus. My apologies. We're going to continue with another wonderful Harry James tune that he made famous. This is You Make Me Love You.
Thank you.
Many wonderful Italian folk songs that are very, very, very famous and have been reworded, or rather rearranged for the big band, with loaded with big band cliches. And Andrea, this may be only the second time you played this one, right? Second or third time?
I played this one time, ITG, maybe Sydney.
Maybe
I forgot, I can't remember. I don't know.
Well, you ought to see him. When we played it, he just was looking at the band, smiling from ear to ear as he heard all this music. It's actually a lot of fun. So this is an Italian medley. Again, let's give it up for the one and only Andrea Giofrini.
Thank you.
thank Andrea Giacuti. Andrea Giacuti, all the way from Italy, to play for us tonight.
Graduating, moving on, doing all sorts of wonderful things. And I'd like to take a moment to recognize those people who are graduating and who you won't get to see here anymore, unfortunately. So we're going to start back in the trumpet section with Trevor Webb, graduate trumpet section. Into the trombone section, Teddy Nagelhort is graduating. On alto saxophone, Nick Johnson graduating. Our entire lovely rhythm section, both teams one and team two, A and B, they are the odd couples of the band. They are all graduating, either undergraduate or graduate degrees. Let's start with the undergraduate degrees. Dan Murray. Woo! Yeah! Ian Morrison, bass. Yeah! Our graduate students, Mr. Tommy Embrick, drums. Yeah! And on bass, Yair Ophir. In addition, you already heard that Allison Kirshner is leaving us as well, so that's too bad. Let's give it for Allison one more time. Did I miss anyone? No, not Brian's coming back. Unfortunately,
Kevin, how can you follow that?
We're gonna follow it. I do not graduate. I get to stay in school forever. So we're gonna get to work with the wonderful musicians coming in, and we've got a lot of wonderful things. So I would encourage you to come back in the fall and watch them grow and become incredible best musicians. We're gonna close with a John Clayton arrangement of The Eternal Triangle, and we're gonna play it as fast as possible. So, buckle your seatbelts. This is The Eternal Triangle.
Thank you. The Schwob Jazz Orchestra. The Schwob Jazz Orchestra. Nick Johnson, Brian Canonigo. Tony Emperor on drums. I'd like to thank the sound crew, Dr. Matt McKay, and all the wonderful people that are putting your smiling faces on the internet right now. We are streaming live. Thank the sound crew. Thank you so much for coming out this year here on the Schwob Jazz Orchestra. Have a wonderful night, and we will see you next year. Take care.